Welcome back, guys, to another PvE build for the Blackwood chapter, this time with my Stamina Sorcerer. I passed with a classic 2H dual setup, with Wrecking Blow as spammable and 2 pets. I managed to get 110k DPS, but I've seen passes with over 115k, but I will definitely not pass 15 hours each class again, like last patch, just to fish for crit luck. I think 110k should be more than enough. I will start with the pass first and then followed by the build showcase. Before the video starts, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Almost 90% are still not sub to my channel. Do me the favor, click on this juicy button and support me, guys. Thanks, my friends. But now let's go. Here we go with the pass. The rotation is extremely easy, as pre-buff summon both pets first, then bound armaments, activate the twilight pet so it deals 50% more damage, daddy cloak with hurricane, and then put the atronach beside the target to be not in combat, step closer, use barb trap into 3-4 wrecking blows until armaments gets 4 stacks. Use armaments then, again, to shoot 4 daggers. It's similar to Merciless or Relentless Focus from the Nightblade. Keep spamming Wrecking Blow until the back bar dots will run out. Then apply your dots. Keep spamming Wrecking Blow in combination with armaments. But don't activate the pets, they will just deal damage passively. Drop Wrecking Blow and Hurricane at 31%. Use only Executioner with Daddy Cloak and Barb Trap instead. If armaments is still up, use it until it ends, but don't reapply it again. That's all. Simple, effective, and really powerful, as you can see. But now enjoy the pass, after I will discuss with you the build. We'll be right back. Did you see the damage of Wrecking Blow, Execution and Armaments? It's ridiculously high. One of the reasons is the new blue CP, Master at Arms. But let me show you the build first. 5 Reliquen on the body. It deals almost 10k single target, so still best in slot. 1 Slime Crawl for extra crit. Then the new mythic item, Harpooner's Wading Kilt, which gives us 10% more crit damage and over 5% crit with 10 stacks. To get those stacks, you only need to do direct damage, which means just keep your normal rotation up. After 10 seconds, you will reach 10 stacks. But watch out, if you get hit by direct damage, you lose 5 stacks. In general, the uptime is between 70 to 100%, depends on the boss. On the jewelry, the good old Dancing Yukida is back with the 2-inch battle axe. Since we have 10% extra crit damage, Yukida is a tiny bit better than Kinnar's. Why we use the battle axe here? It's simple, they increase the axe passive from 8 to 12% crit damage. On the back bar, of course, the Blackwood's Prison dual wield for 6% extra flat damage with poison and the flame damage enchant. On the front bar, we use the double dot poisons, like always. Let's take a look on the skills. Executioner, our execute, which we use at 31% until the end. Bound Armaments, our special ability. Wrecking Blow as spammable. Clan Fear as the first pet. Twilight Matriarch as second pet. Activate both only once, they deal passively damage. As ultimate, Dawnbreaker on the front bar for extra weapon damage. On the back bar, both pets again. We have to slot them on both bars. Deadly Cloak to proc the Black Rose Prison Duel's weapons. It deals good damage too, since they buffed it in this patch. And it gives Mage Evasion too, so really strong. Barb Trap for minor force. Hurricane, another dot. And the Atronarch as ultimate, which deals 10k single targets. Super powerful, this ultimate. As Race, I'm done by here. Khajiit deals similar damage. Orc is also fine. As Mundus, the Thief Mundus, it's a bit better than the Shadow. As Buff Food, still the Lava Food Soup. In Raids, if you don't have sustain issues, you could also use the green Max Stamina Food. Potions, the normal ones, with stamina, major savagery and major brutality. CP wise, only one big change, Master at Arms, which gives us 10% more direct damage. So Wrecking Blow, Armaments, Light Attack, Executioner, all the skills, all the things will get buffed with this juicy CP. The other ones are still the same, Backstabber, Fighting Finesse and Deadly Aim. If you can't flank the enemy, you could use Taumaturge instead of Backstabber. Recipes, Rejuvenation, Ironclad, Boundless Vitality and Slippery. That's the end of the video. Could be possible that I've forgotten something. Type me your questions in the comment section below. I hope you will enjoy the strong PvE setup in raids or dungeons. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys and girls are fine. I will upload in a couple of days the next PvE build. Since then, see ya and have a nice day. Ciao ciao.